Hi, my name is Lynn Levin, and the poem I'm going to read is Idylls of Mayfield. It appears in the anthology Rabbit Ears TV Poems. Idylls of Mayfield is a sestina about the Leave It to Beaver family, the Cleavers, and their friend Eddie Haskell. Mayfield is the fictional town they lived in. Idylls of Mayfield. America during the days of Leave It to Beaver was so gentle, even the war was a cold war. Wally never worried about finding himself, and Ward knew he was blessed with well-adjusted kids and beautiful June, who always looked up to him. Oh, orderly suburbs, oh, Mayfield, whose major troubles came from the mind of Eddie Haskell, who wouldn't quit giving Beave the business. Eddie Haskell, who got Wally to break curfew and urged Beaver to sign up for the modeling agency. Remember Mayfield's Soup Bowl billboard? Beaver scaled it the night of Wally's teen party and got stuck in the bowl. I bet June was hysterical. Next time, don't take foolish dares, counseled Ward, who parented per Spock, spared the rod, and Ward never forgot that he'd been young once. Eddie Haskell wasn't as lucky in the dad department, but did he flatter June? You look lovely today, Mrs. Cleaver. Sure, Beaver understood that Eddie was two-faced, but he was Wally's best friend. I never figured out why in all of Mayfield, Wally couldn't find a better best friend. Anyhow, life after Mayfield wasn't easy for Ken Osmond. He could only look forward to smarmy guy roles and finally became a cop with the LAPD. Was Wally scratching his head about that, thinking how ironic that Eddie Haskell was making other people follow the rules? After Beaver, Jerry Mathers earned a BA in philosophy and a bundle in real estate. June would have been proud, and Eddie was right. June was a vision in shirtwaists and pearls, always dressed to go out in Mayfield, though she never went anywhere. Staying home for Wally and Beaver seemed to fulfill her. She had that kind of grace, and in Ward, a decent guy who managed to smile whenever Eddie Haskell came to the door. Yet, how could that boy not envy Wally? Clean cut, smart, well-liked, a letterman in sports, Wally was ripe for Eddie's corruption, and certainly June kept an eye out, maybe pitied him too, for I suspect Eddie Haskell felt bad about himself, the way the less loved, less talented may feel bad about themselves. The Cleavers found fate kinder. They had Ward, who listened and fixed what he could fix so that Beaver and Wally could have a happy childhood in Mayfield. Sometimes I wish my parents were like June and Ward, but I always laughed when Eddie Haskell messed with Beaver.